And now, ladies and gentlemen, here we go, the Panther Band pregame show. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please stand and remove your hats for the playing of the National Anthem by the Buckeye Local Marching Band and the raising of the American flag by veterans of the American Legions of Jefferson County. And before our National Anthem, we'd like to have a moment of silence. In early December of last year, we mourned the untimely passing of longtime chain gang member Gary Beaver Glover. As many of you know, Beaver was an avid and knowledgeable fan of many sports, with the Panthers, Steelers, Pirates, Penguins, and his beloved Buckeyes as his favorites. He mentored four sons and three nephews through award-winning academic and athletic careers at Buckeye Local, as well as countless others who, though maybe not related to him, received much of the same benevolent guidance and sometimes tough love needed to succeed. The sidelines offered him a vantage point to see high school football close up, and he relished every moment there. Tonight, let's pause to honor the Beav with a moment of silence. Thank you. And now our national anthem. August, and the temperatures are hot. Schools are in session, and football is back in the spotlight. And for the first time in a few years, Buckeye Local opens its season facing its biggest rival, the Martins Ferry Purple Riders. Last year, Dave Bruni's team went 10-2, making it to the second round of the Ohio playoffs. Phil Pest is back at the helm for his third season with the Panthers, who hope to cash in with all of their early season home games. We are set for a good old-fashioned rivalry. It's Martins Ferry. It's Buckeye Local. It's Friday Night Football, and it starts next. It's a warm night here in late August, and it's time for the start of the 2014 OVAC football season. From World War II Memorial Stadium in Yorkville, it's week one of the Ohio High School football regular season. Tonight, it's the Martins Ferry Purple Riders versus the Buckeye Local Panthers. Hello again, everybody. It's great to have you with us. For the first time in 4 years, the Panthers faced the Purple Riders in their opening game of the season. In recent years, the Buckeye 8 Conference implemented a rule that all Buckeye 8 interconference games had to be played the last 7 games of the season. That rule has been lifted this year, thus allowing for an opening week matchup between these two neighboring schools. Martins Ferry made a run into the playoffs last year and hopes to do the same this year. Coach Dave Bruni is beginning his 37th year as a head coach and has 8 returning offensive players and 8 returning defensive players. He made the statement that Martins Ferry has good kids in our senior class. Many are 3-year lettermen. They work hard and are fun to be around. Meanwhile, Coach Pest and the Panthers entered the 2014 campaign with 7 returning offensive players and 8 returning defensive players. They hope to make hay early this year and take advantage of all the early home games. In addition to the must-play Buckeye 8 teams later in the season rule being lifted, the Buckeye 8 has made other changes for this year. The 8-team conference has now grown to 10 teams. Beaver Local and East Liverpool have joined, and Belair and Union Local, who were set to exit the conference, will remain on board. The conference will now have 2 divisions, a North and a South. Competing in the North will be Beaver Local, Buckeye Local, East Liverpool, Edison, and Indian Creek. The South will consist of Belair, Harrison Central, Martins Ferry, St. Clairsville, and Union Local. And Bob, as a result of adding teams and shuffling the schedule to accommodate new teams, the Panthers have ended up with the most front-loaded schedule in the last 15 years.
That's right, Dustin. The first 5 of 7 games are home, including week 3 and 4 against John Marshall and Indian Creek, respectively. After playing a Saturday afternoon game of Belair for week 5, Buckeyes back home for week 6, which is the homecoming game against Edison, and week 7, which is senior night against Beaver Local. The last 3 games of the regular season are on the road, including a Week 10 matchup in Caddis against the Huskies for the Vales Trophy. And speaking of Vales, the boys up here in the booth would like to thank you or congratulate you on your upcoming nuptials on September 20th. Good luck.
Thank you kindly, Bob. And now, ladies and gentlemen, coming up next on the Panther pregame show, Bob will have our official OVAC welcome. The starters for the teams as we await for the Panthers to come out. It's all coming your way next. Season 7 opener, the Panther pregame show.
The Board of Education, Superintendent, Principal, and Athletic Council of the Buckeye Local High School extend to each of you a cordial welcome. We are pleased that you are here tonight. Buckeye Local High School and Martins Ferry High School are members of the Ohio High School Athletic Association and abide by high standards of conduct, competition, and relations with member schools. The athletes in this game are friendly rivals, and while play may be fierce, all in attendance tonight are reminded that this is a game between youngsters and that sporting behavior is expected. The officials assigned to the game have been selected and assigned according to the procedures adopted by the Ohio High School Athletic Association and the Ohio Valley Athletic Conference. Your referee this evening, Keith Bloom. The umpire is Mark Bukalek. Linesman is Peter Brogdon. Line judge is TJ Brain Casio. And the back judge is Jim Sperlaza.